Good afternoon. We start at 4 o'clock with a woman recovering in the hospital after being hit by a stray bullet. She was at a fitness studio, not the target of the attack.
The shooting happened at a strip mall at 53rd and Sheridan in Arvada. And that's where 9 News reporter Katie Eastman has the details.
And the gunshots, they came from this mobile home park. Jefferson County Sheriff's Office says they came across Sheridan Boulevard and into this strip mall, the Berkeley Village Strip Mall, into the businesses here. One woman was shot and two other cars were hit. Jeffco says one car might have been targeted. The second car and the woman who was shot and injured were bystanders caught in the shooting. The Adams County Sheriff says deputies applied 2 tourniquets to the woman who was shot. They say her injuries are not life-threatening. The woman whose car was hit by a bullet heard the noise and didn't realize it was a bullet in her car until police arrived and told her. She was worried about identifying herself for this story, so we didn't show her face on camera.
I know it's not only the hot dog place or the Zumba place or a Walmart or a movie theater. It's like, where can I go? Where can we go that is safe now?
Police have yet to find the man accused of opening fire. They do believe that he has left the mobile home park. In Arvada, Katie Eastman, 9 News.
Police are still searching for a driver who ran off after crashing into an RTD bus stop in Aurora. One woman had to go to the hospital with serious injuries. It happened last night at Colfax and Moline. Police say a car hit 2 people waiting at the bus shelter. We spoke with a woman who works at the dentist office behind the bus stop. She says that she and her coworkers ran out after hearing the crash. That's when they found a woman pinned. They called for help and waited with the woman to try to keep her alert.
Yeah, definitely just try and stop and help. I've always been taught to help others and pray well for others. So just try and do your best and help in whatever way you can, even if it's with a simple water bottle or anything. Just try.
At this point, police say they don't have any detailed suspect information. RTD says they did have a camera at that stop, but they say the crash destroyed it, along with the video. Take a live look outside where we see some blue skies. We've also been seeing some snow fly throughout the day. Mm-hmm. Still about an hour to go before the sun sets.
Yeah, it's been on and off all day long. Kathy, just when I thought it stopped, went outside and there it is again.
Oh, I heard that everywhere I went today, and you both are probably thinking it's never going to stop, right?
Yeah.
This is just going to be
not me. Not
a never-ending winter.
Well, we are going to get a little bit of a break before the next round of cold and snow, and most of the heavier snow shower activity is south of the metro area. Beautiful scene as we look live along the Front Range there with that nice cloud deck. But as we take a look at the regional radar and satellite composite, you can see the winds north to northwest, south to southeast, and all of that moisture upstream is coming right down the I-25 corridor. And in this little river of air, the northwest flow, we've got a couple of weather disturbances. So there have been a couple of enhanced bands of snow today in Douglas County and also up across Jefferson County. We're seeing some improvement with the roads now that we're getting a break and even some clearing up to the north. Blue skies in the Fort Collins area, but snow showers redeveloping over the higher terrain. That northwest flow will bring in more snow to the northern mountains. Temperatures have really not moved a whole lot today. Currently 28 in the city, 30 in Colorado Springs, 29 in Fort Collins. Winds have been pretty light out of the north and northwest, but will be shifting. That's going to help to cut off the flow of moisture coming into the state. So we will see clearing overnight, the snow coming to an end. And believe it or not, you might wake up to sunshine tomorrow, and not just Thursday, Friday as well. So a welcome 48-hour break from the cold and snow ahead of, yes, you've heard it, an Arctic front that's coming in Saturday afternoon. Temperatures have been plenty chilly this afternoon, jacket weather for sure. In Maine weather, we're going to give you some sunshine, a beautiful day tomorrow, and we're going to talk much more about the changes coming over the weekend. So we're not done yet.
Is our good friend Alberta Clipper involved in any of this?
You know, Al's always included in these forecasts in one way or the other.
Oh.
So, yeah, we're sandwiched in between those two weather patterns.
Do we call Al Uncle Al?
Yep. Oh, no, Al. She's
neighbor
she.
Al? Uh-huh. Oh, Alberta.
Alberta.
That's true. Aunt.
You know,
Aunt Alberta.
He's cousins with the polar vortex.
Yeah, well.
Something else we'll be talking about.
Be nice to see her again.
Really?
Not really.
Yeah. The whole fam. Yeah.
Not so much.
Okay, that's
hot
right.
Cocoa, anyone?
See you in a bit with more. Thanks, Kathy.
All right.
More than 500,000 Coloradans will see a big cut to their food stamps in the next couple of months.
That's because the temporary boost to the benefits that was put in place during the pandemic are now set to expire. And despite the rising costs of groceries, 9 News reporter Jaleesa Arizaria is with us now to tell us that SNAP recipients won't be able to appeal this.
Yeah, that's right. During the pandemic, all SNAP recipients got the maximum amount of benefits, but now a federal law has cut that allotment, so people will now simply get what they qualify for. The Department of Human Services says a family of four can see their food stamps cut by $360 beginning in March. We spoke with one single mom worried about the impact this will have on her family.
Pictures don't do it justice. The love a mom can have for her kids and the heartache.
Scary.
Rayanne Remick feels when she thinks of her two children and wonders if in a few months she can adequately support them.
Sorry, I mean to get a picture.
Remick is a school counselor in La Junta. She's one of the more than 550,000 people that will be impacted by a federal law that will cut emergency SNAP benefits put in place during the pandemic. Remick says her monthly benefits will drop from roughly $700 a month to just $60.
Without that money, it's like, okay, I have to change the way we've been living completely. And so that's scary because I do try to give my kids the best of food that I can.
Colorado Department of Human Services knows this cut will be a big blow to a lot of families.
This is not a decision that the State Office of Human Services can reverse.
Carla Maracini is already getting the phone calls.
People are nervous and scared, understandably. This is going to be a really difficult change, which is not only a devastating impact for households who participate in SNAP, but it's going to be a big hit on the Colorado economy that, you know, supports local grocers and retailers and farmers, producers, ranchers.
Remick and others will start seeing the drop in benefits come March. In the meantime, she hopes relief comes to help those she loves.
With how much things are costing right now, there has to be some different answer.
The Department of Human Services is advising people to stock up on non-perishable items and consider freezing produce to make fruits and vegetables last longer. They're also encouraging people to look at other food assistance programs available in the state. Kim and Tom.
This seems especially tough when you consider the people who need this help the most are the ones who are going to be hurt the most severely.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, it's one of those things that this mother that I spoke with said, you know, we're trying the best we can do right now. You know, she is a school counselor. She's trying to provide for her kids. But right now, it's simply not enough. And those benefits were going a really long way for her family.
Yeah. And the rising costs, the cost that we all complain about, those that don't necessarily need this thing. You go to the grocery store and say, that cost more than last week.
Imagine that. You know, she mentioned she's getting $60 now, potentially come March. $60 a month compared to $700. She says, honestly, that might just cover eggs at this point.
Yeah. Oof. Okay. All right. Thanks, Jaleesa.